It's Thursday. I'm sure they're beginning to have a sense of where he is in his progress or lack thereof. From everything you've seen and heard, are they holding on to hope for a late Christmas miracle, or is this just a strategy to throw the Eagles off their preparation?
Thanks, Travis. In 12 days, the Permian cheerleading squad will be competing in the biggest stage of all high school.
Good Friday morning to you, West Texas. Well, we all remember last year's NBA Finals, especially if you were on the losing side. That would be the San Antonio Spurs, in case you forgot.
Thanks, Travis. I'm here live at Grande in anticipation of the rivalry match between Midland and Permian. And boy, does this have the ingredients of a good one.
Well, the past couple of years, the final weeks of the Dallas Cowboys regular season has enough drama that it could land a slot on Bravo after Real Housewives. Yes, I went there.
But what more people are talking about was what happened right before the game ended between Cowboys Marcus Smart and a fan in the front stands. The Steelers' next playoff game will be here at legendary Ratliff Stadium, taking on the Andrews Mustangs, a team which the Steelers beat back in week 4, 61-48, but will be looking a lot different now, especially since losing QB Shane Dolgener to a torn ACL. Still, the Steers know that they're playing a different, potentially better team.
You want 4-3-A? You can't handle 4-3-A, but I'll give you the scoop anyways tonight because it's my job.
Neither the freezing temperature nor the Katie Pope John Paul Lions could stand in Midland Christian's way for its third straight title. But unlike the rest of their regular season games, this game went down to the wire.
Start fast, finish strong, and let's have a bunch of fun today. Get your hands on, let's go.
It wouldn't have mattered where Midland Christian played for its third straight title in Texas. It was going to be cold. But on a Monday afternoon in Corsicana, the Mustangs had its biggest challenge of the year. And when it mattered most, they got hot.
Yeah, it wasn't pretty, but state championship games, I mean, that's what it is. It's just a grind. And that's how you get to the season, that's how you get to the last game, is a grind.
After the grind and the clock wound down to zero in the fourth, this Mustang squad accomplished two feats never done before.
For us to be the first people to ever three-peat and the first people to ever get an undefeated season, it's an honor.
Directly on the sideline for the third time in 4 years was head coach and father, Greg McClendon, who got to see his son and the entire class of 2014 go out as winners.
To be able to have that kind of success with your son is, it's hard to even... We believe with all of our heart we're winners down in our core, and I feel like that's what we finished with is winners. And make no mistake, he's surrounded with great wide receivers, great linemen, a great defense. I'm surrounded by great coaches. It's really special.
Seven times is the number of times Midland Christian has been to the state championship under head coach Greg McClendon. Seven times is also the number of times they've won. Talk about a good winning percentage. From Corsicana, Matthew Villanueva, Big 2 Sports. Travis, this student athlete possesses the rare combination of brains and brawn. She's third in the batting order for the Odessa Broncos and is bound for a premier university. And get this, she hopes to be a surgeon. You got to hear her story. Here is your athlete of the week. When Lindsay Wagner stepped on the field for tryouts as a freshman, she struck the eye of her head coach.
The first thing that stood out to me is her bat. She's very strong, has a solid, consistent bat, and that's what got her to be on varsity from the very beginning.
When I was a freshman, it was really scary. I was the only one on the varsity team.
A junior now, Wagner's nerves have more than settled, and she's more than just a bat.
Every year she's gotten better. You know, she went from honorable mention to second team all-district pitcher, and this year she's on a row so far.
Did we mention that she's one smart cookie?
She's an amazing kid. I mean, how often do you get the number 5 ranked kid on your roster? You didn't ever have to worry about her grades. Her grades this 6 weeks were all 100s and a 99. I mean, that's awesome.
A 3.9 GPA to pair with a 1900 score on her SAT. Wagner knows it's grades that matter most.
That's what's going to get you farther, I think, because without your education, you're not going to go anywhere. And I just put education above everything, I guess.
Good Monday morning to you, West Texas. Yesterday, we turned back the clock for daylight savings, and for many of us, the struggle was real. But for those Texas Tech Red Raiders, time made no difference in the way they played, taking you to Hub City. New Mexico State is in Lubbock for the final day of the 4-day series. Tech trying to clean sweep the Aggies. Bottom of the first, 1-0 Tech. Alec Humphreys on third for Eric Gutierrez. He'll bring him home up with a base hit up the middle. 2-0 Tech. Gutierrez also the owner of a 2-out solo home run in the fourth. Following that is former Midland Christian Mustang Bryant Burleson with a two-run double out to left. Those runs helping him match a career-high 5 RBIs. Tech leads 9-3. It didn't stop there. Very next batter, leave it up to another former Mustang, Hunter Redmond, driving that past the hot corner, bringing in his old buddy Burleson. The Red Raiders going on a win, 14-4, sweeping the Aggies to bring their win streak to 6 games. They now have a 14-3 record. Walking over to Rocky Johnson Field, the final game of the Janine McCaney Memorial Day Classic, Red Raiders beat Northern Colorado earlier 9-1. Facing Abilene Christian in game 2, the bats get going in the third. Sydney Tapia, the 2-run home run, part of a 4-run inning for the Red Raiders. Third inning, Tech now up 6-0. Kiera Miles sends a grounder right through the second baseman's glove. Christy Belsch takes advantage, scores to make it 7-0 after 4 innings. Tech goes on to win 9-1 via run rule win. Brittany Lee ends it with a walk-off home run. Shannon Hayes' team outscoring their opponents 40-8 in 5 wins over the weekend. Red Raiders softball is 18-6 on the season. That's your Monday morning sports. Have yourself a great day and week ahead. And for Big 2 Sports, this is Matthew Villanueva.
Welcome into Big 2 Sports. This afternoon was a lovely one, and tonight was not the exception. The West Texas wind in full effect for the softball rivalry game between Odessa High and Permian. So let's get you started and take you to Ratliff Softball Complex. Permian 2-0 in District, OHS 0-2. Kristen D starting it off right with the strikeout. She'd have 2 in the first inning and many more. Bottom of the first, the Mojo make a play of their own, a double play to be exact, sending the Lady Broncos scoreless. Next inning, one out for Permian. Lady Broncos go tit for tat, getting a double play to counter, sending it to the bottom of the second. It wouldn't be until the seventh inning a run would come about, but it would be a 3-run homer by the Lady Broncos that would put it away. Odessa gets its first district win over the Lady Panthers, 3-0. Another softball score, Lubbock Coronado 1 on the road over the Lady Dogs, sending MHS to 8-5 and 1-2 in district. The Lady Mustangs are now 3-0 in District 2-5A. And one more scoreboard in softball. Those Lady Rebels won on the road in shutout fashion, taking down San Angelo Central 8-0. Lee is now 9-6, 2-0 in district. Next game is against Midland High. The rivalry game will take place at 2 p.m. tomorrow. Heading to the hardwood, Howard College shocked the JUCO world 2 days ago, upsetting the 7th-ranked McLennan in the high-scoring 98-91 affair. Today, they played in the NJCAA semifinals against New Mexico Junior College. Let's take a trip to Lubbock. Winner heads to the finals. New Mexico's Jeff Newberry rises to the rim, baskets good and one. 24-18 Thunderbirds lead. Howard's turn, Eric Leary, corner jumper, count it. Narrows the lead to 24-20. Travis Charles would be battling inside the paint to get his. The lead goes down to only 2, but New Mexico, they've got some shooters. Kenrich Williams would swish the long 2 right here, and the Thunderbirds would wind up winning in a tight one, 64-60, ending Howard's run at the Region 4 championship. Sticking with hoops, upset alert in the Heartland Conference. UTPB survives in overtime against the top-ranked University of Arkansas Fort Smith off a Jason Armstead buzzer-beating three-pointer. What a way to end it. The Falcons will face the winner of Texas A&M International or St. Mary's for an automatic bid to the NCAA Division II tournament. And stepping it up to the association, let's get you caught up with the Mavs and Rockets. Dallas won a huge one, up by 30. They almost gave it away in the final minute where it was tied. Instead, they win by 5 over a tough Trailblazers. And over in H-Town, the Rockets are leading in a landslide. Last time we checked, 76-53. Still a lot more ball to be played in that one. Well, Tuesday night, Chris Birch resigned as athletic director and football head coach of the Indians. Today, Birch has found a new job out east as the head football coach with Frisco Liberty. I spoke with him earlier today to discuss the recent hire, and while he said he and his family are elated about the new opportunity, leaving a place he's called home for well over a decade isn't going to be easy.
That's going to be really tough. Great friends, great families that were going to leave, football players that are like sons and administrators that are father figures and brothers, and so it's going to be hard, plus a church that we really love, and so you know it's going to be tough, but you know where one door closes, there's always another door opening, and that's what God's allowed right here.
A true act of perseverance, Shelby. You know, 3 days ago he didn't have a job, and today he's moving up to Frisco, a nice 4A school, well, soon to be 5A.
I like that saying, when one door closes, another one opens.
Nothing truer.
Thank you, Matthew. We'll be right back.